plants. Today we will study about the plants which are green in color, why they are green in color, and what is the importance of green plants in our life. So let us start our topic. Before doing the topic green plants, we will study about the parts of plants. You all have seen plants around you. Different types of plants you have seen. Some are very small, some are of medium size, and some are very tall. So there are different types of plants based on their height, structure, and the type of climate they are in. So, but different plants have their common body structure. Different plants have their common body structure. It means they are having common parts. For example, we, human being, whether any human being is in India or in America, the body structure of the human being will be same. They will be having two eyes, one nose, two ears, one mouth, one face, two legs, two arms and all. And same as bitter, plants are also having same structure. It means parts of plants are also same. So let us start with parts of plant. The diagram you have seen, is it is the basic diagram of a plant. The plant is having bitter two main parts. One part which is below the ground. As we all know that plants grow in the soil. So one part is below the ground and one part is above the ground. One part is below the ground and one part is above the ground. The part of the plant which is below the ground, the part of the plant which is below the ground, that part is known as the root system. That part is known as root system. And the part of the plant which is above the ground, the part of the plant which is above the ground is known as shoot system. That is known as shoot system. So basically there are two main parts of the plant. One which is below the ground, that is root system. One which is above the ground, that is shoot system. Root system consists of roots. Root system consists of roots. And the shoot system of the plant which is above the ground. The shoot system of the plant which is above the ground contains many parts. The one basic structural part of the plant is stem. This part of the plant is stem. Stem is that part of the plant which gives support to the plant to stand straight. Which gives support to the plant to stand straight. Only the stem keeps the plant upright. Only the stem helps to keep the plant upright. These extended part of the stem, these extended part of the stem is known as the branches. These extended part of the plant is known as branches, on which you can see different more parts of the plants. Then next is which are these leaves. These are leaves. You must have seen all of you leaves of the plants. Some plants are having few leaves, but some plants are having many number of leaves. Some plants are having green leaves. Some plants are having yellow leaves. You have all have seen different types of leaves around. Next, this structure, the very colorful, beautiful structure is flower. You all know that what is flower? The beautiful, attractive structure of the plant is known as, and colorful also, which is known as flower. These are which are fruits. These are fruits which we take, which we consume for our eating. Fine? And these at the nodes, at the starting point of the branches, the structure you see, these, this structure is known as bud. This structure is known as bud. Now let us start revising the functions of each and every part. Then we will continue our next topic. The first part of the plant which we have done is roots. Roots are those parts of the plant which is below the ground. Roots. Roots fixes the plant in the ground. Root fixes the plant in the ground. For example, if you will see, this is the stem of the plant or a tree. This is the stem of the plant. If I keep it like this, it cannot stand straight until a support is there at the bottom. Same the way the roots fixes, the roots which are attached. the stem fixes the plant in the soil. First function of roots we have done. The second function of the roots is, as we all know that roots are present in the soil. Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil and give it to the stem, and stem give those water and minerals to all the parts of the plant so that the plant can grow properly. Right? Next is our stem. As I have already told you, stem keeps the plant upright. Stem keeps the plant upright. Stem takes water and minerals from the roots and give it to all the parts of the plant. Stem takes water and minerals from the roots and give it to all the parts of the plant. Stem is that structure of the plant which bears other parts of the plant like flower, fruit, buds, leaves, branches, etc. Next is our bud. Bud is that part of the plant which grows and changes into flowers. Bud is that part of the plant which grows and changes into flowers. Like a baby grow and change into an adult human being, same the way this bud grows and change into flower. Next is leaf. The structure you all can see, this leaf. Leaf is very important part of the plant. We will study about structure of leaf and functions of leaf in this chapter also. Leaf is that part of the plant which prepares the food for the plant. Right? And leaf is also important, as leaf helps the plant. Leaf helps the plant to breathe. Like you inhale the air through your nostrils, this nose, right? Same the way, leaves are those parts of the plant which help the plants to breathe. Breathe means take in air and give out air. Next is branches. Branches, I have already told you, the extended part of the stem which bears flowers, fruits, leaves, buds, etc. Next is flower. As already told you, that flowers are the most attractive and colorful part of the plant, and flowers contain seeds. That is why when flowers grow, like I have told you, buds grow, they change into flower. But when flowers grow, they change into fruits. Good morning, students. I welcome you all to RKP online classes. In the previous video, we have done parts of plants, and I have told you that some plants are green in color and some parts plants are not in green color. So we will do this topic only plants which are of two types. One which are in green color, those types of plants are known as green plants, and one which are not in green color, those types of plants are known as non-green plants. So why some plants are green in color and some plants are not in green color? It is because, beta, some plants contain a pigment known as chlorophyll. What it is known as? Chlorophyll. Chlorophyll. Some plants contain a pigment known as chlorophyll, which gives green color to the plant. That is why they contain green color and they appear to be in green color, and we have given the name to them as green plants. But some plants do not contain this pigment. Which pigment? Chlorophyll. Some plants do not contain this pigment, which is known as chlorophyll. That is why they do not have green color and they are known as non-green plant. Now, we have seen different types of plants. Some are short, which are known as herbs. Some are medium sized, which are known as shrubs. And some are very tall, which are known as trees. If you will look herbs, for example, tulsi. If you will look the plant tulsi, you will see the stem of the tulsi is also in green color. The branches of the tulsi is also in green color. And the leaves of the tulsi is also in green color. It means herbs contain chlorophyll in their stems also, in their branches also, as well as in their leaves also. That is why all these three parts of the tulsi plants, means herbs, are in green color. So what I meant to say, द प्लांट कंटेन क्लोरोफिल दोज प्लांट्स आर नोन एज ग्रीन प्लांट्स एंड सम प्लांट्स कंटेन क्लोरोफिल इन मेनी पार्ट्स बट सम प्लांट्स कंटेन क्लोरोफिल ओनली इन देयर सिंगल पार्ट दैट पार्ट इज बेटर लीव इफ यू हैव सीन ट्रीज और श्रब्स श्रब्स लाइक लेमन रोज जैस्मिन hibiscus etc if you will look carefully the branches and the stem of the plant the branches and the stem of the plant are brown in color but the leaves of those plants shrubs as well as the trees the leaves of those plants are green in color because the leaves only contain this green pigment which is known as chlorophyll that is why they are having green color and they are known as green plants for example if you talk about the trees the trunk of the tree is woody hard and brown in color the branches are also brown in color but the leaves of the trees are green in color if the leaves of the trees are green in color it means they contain this pigment which is known as chlorophyll but if you will look at the plants like mushroom if you will look at the plant like mushroom not even a single part is green in color it means that plant does not contain this pigment chlorophyll that is why they are not in green color that is why they are known as non green plants so what we have done in this topic that many plants contain a pigment in them which is known as chlorophyll that gives green color to the plant and that is why they are known as green plants but the function of chlorophyll is not only to give green plant what is the main function of having green color of the plants it is not that if plants are green in color that is why they are useful to us but how they are useful to us why they are useful to us what is the importance of this pigment chlorophyll only to give green color to the plants no the chlorophyll is very important for the plants This we will discuss in the next topic of our chapter that is leaf. So let us revise this topic. Two types of plants we have done: green plants and non-green plants. What are green plants? Green plants are those plants which are green in color. And why they are green in color? Because they contain chlorophyll. In some plants, stem, branches, and leaves all are in green color because all those parts contain chlorophyll. But in some plants only leaves are in green color because only leaves contain chlorophyll and the second type is which are non green plants non green plants are those plants which do not contain chlorophyll that is why they are not in green color okay